So what have you done today to make you feel proud?
Hello everyone, welcome to this week's Friday Assembly. Now I'm going to start with a swallow update because I went to visit my brother this week and it was really exciting to see the Simon and Sally swooping through into the garage, actually parked under where the nest was, and seeing them flying straight in and out to feed the chicks. And also actually while we sat in the garden having our picnic, they came and sat on the telegraph wires overhead. That was really nice as well. So I've got some exciting footage to show you just now. Well, here are Simon and Sally, the proud parents, looking down at the nest. You can see the camera there as well. So this is just inside, it's an outbuilding. It's a bit like a garage. Well, it is a garage, but it's got no front on it. And the swallows fly straight through the doorway. And the nest's just on the inside of the front part of the garage. And here are the chicks peeping out of the nest. So I think my brother took these from down on the ground, looking up at the nest. And then this one's actually from last Friday. So it was just after I'd done the last assembly. And you can see the nest was already looking pretty full. Here comes Simon or Sally with some food for the chicks. So even though they're quite big, their parents still feed them. So if you can imagine, Simon and Sally must be working really hard to feed these growing chicks. And then by Monday, it was really quite cozy. And then this one's from Wednesday, and there doesn't really seem to be space for all five chicks. There only seem to be four in the nest, and then one's having to perch on the side there. They look really wedged in together. And this little video is from Wednesday as well. And if you have a look, one of them's just preening its feathers, and you can really see, especially on the wings there, that the feathers have developed really well. If you remember, they had no feathers when they were born, when they first hatched. And then they were very fluffy, but now they're getting those proper feathers ready for flight, because hopefully soon they'll start having a little go at flying. Now this last little video is a montage that my brother put together, and it's really just photos from all the way through from when the nest was first built or made nice again, because they came back to their nest from last year, all the way up until I think it was Tuesday this week. So it really helps just to see, because it's hard to remember what they looked like when they first hatched out, when we see them looking so big now. So we'll have another look next week. I wonder if I'll be able to show you some little clips of them having a go at flying. I hope so. This week's story that I wanted to share with you is called The Penguin Who Wanted to Fly. And this has been lent to me by Miss Haddon and Penguins Class. Now I know there's another penguin story actually of Miss Haddon's that Mrs. Sparks has been reading on the YouTube channel. So have a look for that one as well. Okay, The Penguin Who Wanted to Fly by Catherine Barth. Flip-Flop sat on his favourite thinking rock and looked up into the sky. I wish I could fly, he said to himself. Flip-Flop stood up. He looked down at his wings and flapped them. Nothing happened. Flip-Flop couldn't fly. That night, Flip-Flop had a dream. He dreamt he was flying. It was so quiet and so peaceful up there in the starry sky. Can you see the little owl there as well? Flying, so he wants to fly just like that owl. Next morning, Flip-Flop had an idea. He would make himself some wings. Can I help? Asked Polar Bear. Flip-Flop climbed on top of Polar Bear and flapped his wings. Flap, flap. Flop. Oops, said Flip-Flop, but it didn't matter. Flip-Flop had another idea. Just the thing, said Flip-Flop, as he pulled out his special helicopter hat from his dressing-up trunk. I wonder if this one will work. He spun around and around and around and around, spinning faster and faster, until he spun out of control. Ouch! Cried Flip-Flop as he flopped to the ground. I feel very dizzy. That night, it snowed. In the morning, Flip-Flop was excited as he thought of another idea. He would build an aeroplane out of snow. A snowplane. Flip-Flop was very pleased with himself as he climbed in. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. He waited for his new snowplane to take off and waited and waited. Oh dear, sighed Flip-Flop as the sun came out and melted his snowplane. But it didn't matter. Flip-Flop had another idea, a better idea. He got a balloon and tied a piece of string to it. The balloon floated upwards, and so did Flip-Flop. I'm flying, said Flip-Flop excitedly. I am really flying. And so he was, until... Pop, went the balloon. Flop, went Flip-Flop. Poor Flip-Flop. I am never going to fly, he cried. Polar Bear gave his friend a hug. Come with me, he said. Polar Bear gave Flip-Flop a gentle push down their favourite slippy slide. Whoosh! Flip-Flop whizzed down the ice. Whee! I'm flying! Squealed Flip-Flop. But then... Splash! Help! Cried Flip-Flop as he crashed into the sea.
Mummy,
it was very peaceful and quiet down there under the sea. There were lots of fish and other floaty things. Wow, said Flip-Flop. This is just like flying. Flip-Flop couldn't really fly, but that didn't matter because Flip-Flop could swim. In fact, he could swim quite beautifully. We've really enjoyed that story. Thank you, Miss Haddon and the penguins. It was great to see that Flip-Flop discovered in the end that he was just perfect as he was. He wanted to be like those birds flying high in the sky. And he realised he had special skills all of his own. And he was just right, just as he was. And what a lovely friend he had as well with Polar Bear. I really like that hug. Let me show you again. That Polar Bear, his friend, gives him. Isn't that lovely? What a lovely friend. There we go. I wonder what your special skill is. Maybe you've found it. Maybe you haven't found it yet. But you're just right, just as you are. Thank you for joining me for my assembly, and I'll see you next week. Bye.
Stop.
so many answers, I don't know. So do it today, yeah. Cause I can see a clear horizon.
What have you done today to make you feel
right? Yeah. Let me hear ya. So what have you done today to make you feel proud? Yeah. Cause you could be so mad.
So what?